हाय गाइस, वेलकम टू कोर आर्टिजन लैब। दिस इज वीडियो नंबर 17 फॉर होटल मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम इन लारावेल। एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर मेनली गोइंग टू परफॉर्म द बुकिंग मॉडल टास्क। ओके, सो द फर्स्ट थिंग वी आर गोइंग टू डू, वी विल क्रिएट द बुकिंग मॉडल। ओके, सो दैट कस्टमर कैन बुक द रूम अकॉर्डिंग टू द टाइप। ओके, सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर जस्ट गोइंग टू क्रिएट द टेबल और यू कैन से द मॉडल। देन वी विल डिफाइन द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द बुकिंग मॉडल एंड द रूम मॉडल, एंड वी विल ऑल्सो डिफाइन द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द बुकिंग मॉडल एंड द कस्टमर। बिकॉज वेन कस्टमर बुक द मॉडल, देन इट विल कस्टमर सेलेक्ट द रूम एंड वी विल डिफाइन द रिलेशन बिटवीन द बुकिंग मॉडल एंड द कस्टमर ऑल्सो। ओके, सो इन दिस वे वी विल डिफाइन अवर मॉडल एंड रिलेशनशिप। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टू डू दिस। सो द फर्स्ट थिंग वी आर गोइंग टू डू, we will create model. Okay, so I will open the app, I will open the CMD. Okay, and I'm in the app now. I will run the command php artisan make model booking. Okay, and of course I will create the migration with minus m flag. So after running this, it will show the message that model has been created and migration is also created. So I'll go to the migration file. So here we have, I'll go to the database and I'll go to the migration, and here we have booking. Okay, so now what we will do here. Okay, so the one thing that I need to do, one thing I need to do, it is not syntax, the syntax is not highlighting because I have installed some package. I need to remove that package. So I will remove package, and the package name is Naomi. I will remove this. Okay, so it has been removed and you can see the highlighted text, highlighted strings. Okay, according to the keywords like class and all the things. Okay, so this is our migration file. Now in this is the primary ID and this is created and updated column. Now we will create the first thing we will create, that is integer, and that is our customer ID. Okay, and the second thing is we will create the room ID. Okay, room ID. Okay, now the another thing is, okay, so it will say like we want to, when customer book the room, we will say we will take the check-in date. So check-in date. Okay, then we will define the checkout date. Okay, and how many member that they are booking, for how many members for booking. Okay, so we will say, we will define in two parts, total adults, okay, and total children. Okay, if you want to add more column, then you can add. Okay, so total adults, total children, check-in date, check-out date. Okay, and here we are selecting the room, and after saving the customer detail, we will get the ID and we will save the booking also. Okay, so this is the process we will do. Okay, so total, this is total adults, total children. Okay, and yeah, this is fine. If we need, then we will define another columns. Okay, so we have defined our migration. Now let's migrate this so that it will create the table in database, manage.py migrate. Sorry, I am running the Django command. Actually, this will be php artisan migrate. Okay, so migration has been successful. Let's go to the database. So here we have php my admin. okay, and let's go to here, portal manage, and here we can see that here we have, where it is, bookings. Here you can see that. Okay, so in this we have a customer ID, room ID. Okay, so this primary key customer. Okay, so this ID will be go as a foreign key in the bookings table, and the rooms. Okay, so the room ID will be go in the booking table. Okay, so in this way we will save the booking data here. Okay, and now let's define the relationship between the room and booking and customer and booking. These two relationship we need to define. So the first relationship, let's go to the booking. I will open the booking.php, and here we will define function customer, because every booking belongs to some customer. Okay, not some, only one customer. Every booking belongs to any customer. So this will be return, okay, dollar this belongs to, and here we will define customer class. Okay, so this is the thing. Okay, so now we will also define, so this booking also belongs to room. Okay, any specific room, so this will be room class. Okay, so if your table name is customers, like suppose here if you have any other primary ID, like if you have defined custom primary ID, then you can add here. Okay, because I have defined, you can see in the bookings table, I have defined the customer ID, I have defined the room ID, because our relational table name is customers, and room ID table is rooms, so that I have defined customer ID, room ID. Okay, if your table name is different, then this will not work. Okay, you need to define you need to define this foreign key here. Okay, if you have defined some, if your customer table name is not customers, then you need to define yours, whatever you have defined, you need to define here. Okay, whatever you have defined here, you need to add it here. Okay, so that in this way you can define the belongs to relationship. Okay, so I hope you understand what I want to say. If you have any query, any doubt, then please add in the comment section. Okay, we have also defined this relationship, our room in our, you can see here the room type. Okay, here you can see that in the room type, because every room type belongs to some room. Okay, so that in the room we have defined this room type, and similarly in the booking we have defined the customer, and because booking belongs to customer and room, so that we have defined these two things. Okay, and similarly if you do more attention on this, then similarly any customer can define multiple bookings. So we have to define the bookings, because this customer, because one customer may be create multiple bookings, so that it is bookings, because this is number of bookings. Okay, so this will return $this has many, and has many what? Booking. Okay, booking class. Okay, so if you have defined any foreign key custom, then you can add it here. Okay, I have explained this in a few seconds before, that why we need to add the foreign key here. Okay, and why we not need to add it here. And you can see this Laravel documentation if you want to understand more precisely, then you can refer the Laravel documentation. They have explained very beautifully. Okay, if you can just go to the laravel.com and just go to the database, or you can search ORM, then you can find everything. Okay, so just simply search, or you can simply search model relationship. Here you can see that model, where it is. So you can see that allocant ORM, and here you can just search. Let's search here, has many. So here you can see that allocant relationship, allocant ORM relationship. So this is the thing. Okay, so you can refer this documentation to clear all your doubts. And if you want to learn more about the Laravel allocant or ORM, then you can study here. They have explained very beautifully. Okay, so we have created our model for receiving the bookings. We have defined the relationship between the booking and the room. We have defined the relationship between the booking and customer. Now what we need to do in the next video, I will do create a booking form, and we will take the customer information. I will create the booking form, not in the admin panel but in the front. Okay, so I will take the information from the customer, and we will take every information that we have defined in our migration file, and then we will save the booking, and we will also attach the payment gateway. Okay, so that customer can pay and then he can book the room. Okay, and here we will manage all in the admin section, we will manage all the things. Okay, so I hope you understand. This is first step for booking section, and in the next video we will do the second step and the third. I will try to complete the booking section in the three videos. So this is the first, and then we will do another. Okay, so I hope you understand all the things. If you have any doubt, any query, then please add in the comment section. So thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, share, subscribe this channel, and thank you so much.